Dr. Cass, I'd like to ask you if we could do a little series on what I call health cascades. The first one is that we've been talking about adrenals off and on. Can you explain again briefly what adrenals are, but the cascade that begins once the adrenals are not working properly?
Well, let's start with what the adrenals do. What are they?
Yes.
They're these tiny glands, really, you know, maybe about the size or shape of an almond. Mm-hmm. And they sit just above the kidneys in the back. And they're our flight or fight mechanism. Okay. And that means that they developed a very long time ago. And in fact, in all animals, when there's an emergency, when you have to run from an enemy or fight an enemy, you start to pump adrenaline, right? Because mm-hmm. you need to have increased blood flow to your muscles, increased heart rate, increased respiration, your eyes widen, your palms get sweaty. This is the fight or flight response, the emergency response. We have this nowadays too when the adrenals kick in. If you're feeling stressed about, you have to give a presentation, or you're standing in line and you're late and you know that the line better move and it's not moving and you're feeling stressed and your heart rate goes up and your palms get sweaty, mm-hmm. or if you have to give a speech, that's a really big one for a lot of people.
Or 30 phone calls you don't plan on a day.
Yes. So here you are pumping out adrenaline, and then after a while what happens, you're not only in this stress response, pumping out adrenaline, but then cortisol kicks in, which is the other stress hormone that's put out by another part of the adrenal gland called the adrenal cortex. Mm-hmm. So the adrenaline is put out by the center part called the adrenal medulla, but the cortex puts out cortisol. So these are the two, that's like the 1-2 punch for dealing with stress. And we needed Dr. Hans Selye, who was a scientist out of Montreal, first posited this whole idea of the fight or flight response, and he did experiments with animals and then and showed that this happened with people as well, that after a while, when you have the fight or flight response going on constantly, you end up kind of burning out, and you're not able to handle it anymore. So when a stressful event happens, you can't get that energy up. And I've had people come to me, As a doctor, they've come to me and said, I'm just exhausted. I said, do you tend to work on deadlines and, wait till the last minute to do things? Yep. I said, and have you noticed, and this is what I'll ask, have you noticed that you sort of can't get that energy up for the deadline anymore like you used to? You used to be able to do your homework paper in college, and now you can't get that momentum up right at the last minute like you, yeah, exactly. I said, it's your adrenals. They've given out on you.
So we need to learn a lot more about our adrenals. Do you mention adrenals in any of your books?
I do. I have a whole section in Natural Highs and a whole section in 8 Weeks to Vibrant Health where I talk about the adrenals and the relationship of the adrenals and the thyroid gland, which runs our metabolism.
And if we want to learn more about your books, we can go to drcass.com, right?
Yes, drcass.com.
Well, stress has to be one of the biggest problems that we have in our society today. I certainly would advise people to learn more about their adrenals, and Natural Highs or your other books is a great place to start. Thank you.
Thanks.